hope you guys like this because I had so much fun filming this, and they're my favorite kinds of videos to watch and to film because I love to craft. So I figured I'd show you all the little crafts that I did for my room, and now that means I could do a room tour. So like this video if you want to see a room tour after this, because I'm really excited about it because this is the cleanest my room has ever been in my whole life. But anyway, let's just get on into the crafts, and I hope you guys like it. So here we go. So you're obviously going to need a monogram, so either you're going to have to draw it or print it off online just like I did. So I will link that website down below that I printed this off of, as long as all the instructions and materials you're going to need for all the crafts in the video. So just cut out the monogram, obviously, as you can see, and then later on we are just going to tape it onto our paper. And this paper is actually a shopping bag I bought at Target. I just really wanted it to be chevron, and that's just all they had. So just find a paper or canvas or whatever you want, and then just cut that out to the size you want it to be. So you're going to need to trace it onto your paper, so I'm just taping it just to make it easier for myself to trace, just because I'm a terrible tracer. So just tape it on, or just trace it without taping it. Or if you're a really good drawer, just draw the monogram directly onto the paper, whatever works best for you. And then the next step is just take some Elmer's glue and then just glue the outline of the monogram and also the inside of the letters, and then you're just going to pour the glitter on top of that. And I recommend going letter by letter because the glue dries pretty quickly and then the glitter won't stick, and that will just defeat the whole purpose. So yeah, that's just a really easy way to make a glitter monogram, and I hope you guys liked it. So for this one, you're obviously going to need glitter, and I'm just using two different kinds. One is a bigger size glitter and the other one is a fine size one, just so it can fit into all the little cracks. So I'm just going to mix that up into a cup and then just taking Elmer's glue and just painting my whole jar with it. And this is actually an old pickle jar, so any jar will do for this step, and then just pour all the glitter onto it. So this next DIY is just as easy as the last one, except for this one extra step, and that's to paint the initials before you put the glitter on, just because then you make sure that it's opaque. So just match up your paint color with the glitter color you're using, and then it's the rest of the exact same steps as the Vase DIY. For this DIY, I tried to take the simple quote canvas and just make it a little more interesting. So first I just printed out the quote that I wanted to put on the canvas or the board. In my case, I put in a picture frame, and then I just cut all the letters out, and I'm just going to use these as a stencil. All these black and white photos, so all I did was just turn them around and trace the letters onto the back and make sure the letters are backwards, because then you will just have the back of a picture and that will just be awkward. And then I just cut them all out. All it's left to do is put them on your canvas or your piece of paper, and I'm just using this fancy little glue thing I got at Michael's, but you can use tape or regular glue, and just put all the letters onto the canvas the way you want. My DIY, you're just gonna need some cork boards and also some fabric, and I bought both of these at Walmart, so they're definitely highly accessible and affordable. Then you're just gonna cut the fabric around the cork board, leaving about a half an inch. So now just take a glue gun and glue the sides of the cork boards, and then just fold over the excess fabric and make sure it sticks onto the glue. But be careful not to burn yourself, because trust me, I did that. And that is it. It's very simple, and just take the adhesive it comes with to stick it onto your wall. As you can see, I'm doing that over here. And that is it for the DIYs. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and let me know how you guys liked it and if you tried out the DIYs. Plus, be sure to check out for my room tour that I'm going to be uploading very soon. So, bye guys!